So the next property is we can't broken down by physical methods. That is, if you are a compound is prepared means we can't broken down that elements in that compound by some physical methods. For example, filtration, some physical methods. No, in that using that method we can't broken down the compound to again to get the element. Okay, but we can separate the elements and compound by some chemical methods. So for example, sodium chloride is a compound. We can separate the sodium and chlorine by chemical methods. Okay, we didn't broken down into sodium and chlorine by some physical methods, some filtration, that and all. We can't broken down into elements. Okay, so what are the properties of compounds? First one is that the elements are combined in a fixed proportion, then only we get the compound. Okay, then next one is that the property of compound is entirely different from the properties of that elements, what are constituent elements present in that compound. Okay, the third point is we cannot broken down that compound by physical method, but we can separate that elements which is present in the compound by some chemical methods. Okay, these are the properties of compounds. So the next one is symbol of an element. So what is meant by symbol of an element is it is the short representation of an element. Okay, for example, hydrogen means you are writing H, mean H, no, capital H. For carbon means you are writing capital C, no, that is capital C means in chemistry capital C means carbon, capital H means hydrogen. So symbol is a short representation of an element. Okay, then symbol, that symbol is usually derived from the its English name or its Latin name. Okay, that symbol of an element, it's usually derived from its English name or from Latin name. Okay, these symbols are allocated by the IUPAC, that is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. Okay, the symbols are allocated by International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, that is IUPAC. Okay, then Dalton was the first scientist. He introduced to use the symbols for element. Okay, in a very specific sense. So who first introduced that symbols for elements? Dalton. Dalton was the first scientist. He introduced to use the symbols for the elements. Okay, then Berzelius. Berzelius is another one scientist. He suggested that the symbol of elements may break from one or two letters of the name of the element. Okay, but again the Berzelius, he one more scientist, he changed that. What he said is we can use one first letter or first and second letters of the name of the element of from English name or Latin name. Okay, so this is about the symbol of an element. In the next class we will see the rules, what are the rules followed in writing a symbol of an element. Okay, next class we will see. In this class I given two activities, ma. I will send the pages through WhatsApp. Please go through it. Okay, the next class I will say the answer. Okay, thank you.